house of trash. My dinner was American Indian.
But our cousins, our relatives, the Syrians,
yeah,
said this. Literally, you know, they in Damascus, when they hung, up to now in Damascus, and during my father's time, when a man is hung, they actually write his record on a big tree, and they hung it on his neck.
You do it now.
Up to now, and during my father's time, his classmates were hung, and according to him, they put a big placard in front, the smoking record, not for him to read, but for others to read. And they hung it, they actually hung it on his neck, and they hung it. Up to now, Akka does it now, and Jimmy Tan is dead. So that is when they don't take it figuratively. They take it literally. Like you said.
Can you think of a good idiot, an American idiot?
Idiot?
What was his name of itself?
Oh, I think he was an
American
idiot.
That's
what it was.
Which one? The line of the parties was a
big thing. Or something rather.
One thing or another. Yes, the record to mine is back. Like raining dogs and cats. It doesn't really rain dogs and cats. You don't get it, you get the record behind your back. That just means you have a bad record. Yeah. Oh yeah. The reason everybody will be in hell initially is because God will not be there. In the absence of God, it is hell. So then God comes and becomes heaven for the believers and becomes a worse hell for the disbelievers. Right. You're going to hell. Oh, everybody is. Even Jesus and Muhammad and Moses.
Well, yeah, but I mean, like somebody
who hasn't seen
the sin or no one else.
Yeah, everybody. Everybody is in hell. Let me explain this point a little bit. We're told that this initial hell will serve to make you appreciate heaven, because you do not appreciate the good thing unless you know what the bad thing is like. Right. Exactly. But you see, hell is not what they picture to you, the fire and the destiny. It's a terrible place, but the terrible thing about it is eternity and hopelessness. So that initial hell is not eternal, and it is not hopeless.
That's why Rashid and I were suggesting to say, 2 years.
We'll pass through that.
We'll pass by
hell. Go to the means to stay. Yeah. You know, or no permanent stay.
We'll be transient.
Like you are. Just a transient camp instead of
May I just mention something? May I mention something in the famous Nicaean Creed, which was declared in the Council of Nicaea. It says that, talking about Jesus Christ, as part of the belief, then he descended into hell, and then ascended into heaven. It's very impressive.
What is this,
man? The Apostles' Creed. I think that, like, you know, how he died, Jesus Christ, and so. Then he descended into hell, and then he ascended into heaven. Which is very, very impressive.
That's
very close
to the Quran. You compare two whole lines. You can see that verse. So initially we all go to him. Every single one of you will initially enter therein. This is an inevitable matter decreed by the Lord. It is written in the most very powerful words in Arabic. وَإِنْ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَلِدُهُ كَانَ عَلَى رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيًّا. It is inevitable matter decreed by God.
Your son will be taken out.
I remember...
Your son will be...
Yeah, then read the next verse, 72. Says, then we save those who work righteousness, leaving the wicked, they are humiliated. It only makes sense because the sequence of events in the hereafter is that you will be resurrected first. Now, when you are resurrected and God is not there physically, then God comes literally. So, the period of absence of God's physical presence is hell. Purgatory will be for people who didn't make it to heaven and didn't make it to hell. People who said La ilaha illallah like a year and a half before they died. They didn't get the chance to grow.
Hypocrites
would be in the deepest hell.
And then you go and visit him, right?
But those people according to Quran, they have powers of discernment because they know they can recognize, they know who are the ones.
Yeah, everybody recognizes everybody.
No, I'm talking this particular one, but this one is the Arab. They know by the marks of certain people that have prostrated, they know by the marks of the others that they're going to. So they are people of discernment. I don't know if that's the word that you people. The people who have discernment.
Everybody will recognize everybody by the look.
They
will sneak into heaven, but they will suffer even worse. For the presence of God, the baby's soul suffer more in the presence of God in heaven. So when they sneak up to heaven, they come closer to God and they cannot stand it. They shatter and they go back voluntarily, they go back to hell. Then hell is so bad, so they sneak back again. They will spend eternity in circulating in this way. You keep hoping that maybe when they come closer to God, they will be able to stand it, but they can't, so they go back. So it breaks the monopoly for them, isn't it? You will spend the eternity circulating between hell and a worse hell in heaven. That sounds ironic, isn't it? So that's why when God comes, the people whose souls are grown will enjoy to be in heaven automatically. And the ones whose souls are small and shrunk will suffer too. So it will be worse hell. Worse than hell. And the proof is that they voluntarily go back to hell. the mountain. We come to you. You're also Abdullah, aren't you? We're all Abdullah.
When Abraham said, my Lord will tell you like that, he said, do you have me? He said, it is illegal, I need to eat in my heart. But I said, take 4 words and I'll employ the heart, and pray, eat will be close from top or hill. Then call them and they will come to your plan. You can realize that God is Almighty way. I guess the main idea here is everybody, all the believers, somehow assume because the thing is, we have believers. And the faith is pushing out that maybe we are not, we are going to see ourselves. Abraham is a great believer, even then, he may be sure. So you can think, I would say, just for yourself to go into the maybe as other words that the miracle that's seen by everybody in the time of war or something, that was a miracle of our work. Or it can be individual. Not that there is the kind of thing here, but it could be something that it could be a miracle. For the people, for the person that in that case God will be good people if they really open this
that.
The question here was, Abraham, do you not believe? Of course, Abraham doesn't believe. But he is there too. We have a very good example for our group here. We were very, very fortunate, and we have the unique, great portion of having the miraculous Quran come out of this mosque. To the whole world, proving that every word in this Quran is from God. It's a very indescribable, great, very humbling discovery, and we didn't realize how great it is in this mosque, but I guess we do. We do realize how great it is, but I'm sure each one of you met people who say, when we begin the Quran from God, we don't need this. So in other words, they're saying, we are better than Abraham. We don't need the Ashura.
We did believe that the Quran is from God before the discovery of this verse in the Quran. But when we saw it, our faith strengthened, like God said in Surah 74, after the number 19. God said to strengthen the faith of the believers. So our faith was strengthened. So this example here of Abraham wanting, needing a reassurance means that the sincere believers need reassurance and request reassurance. And there is nothing wrong with it. Also, the verse here has an actual incident where Abraham took four birds and studied the markings on the birds. And then he cut the birds in pieces and put them one piece of each on the top of a hill. Far, far apart. And when he called them, God actually put the birds together. The same bird. This is why he studied the markings first. Of course, God had the answers to that. He doesn't have to do it himself. It was all done by his command. So this is an actual incident showing resurrection of the dead. And the verse before this, you remember, the guy was resurrected from death after 100 years. The belief in resurrection is very important. It is required along with belief in God. So we're going to quit now, but yes, I want to remind you that as you will see throughout the verses of the Quran, it is very important that we develop our soul and grow. The more you grow, the higher is your rank for eternity. And one of the most intensive worships that make you grow is making dhikr at dawn. It's really a shame to sleep through it when there's a treasure going on right here in this mosque at dawn. So don't sleep through it. It's not terrible, you know, to just wake up and come to the mosque at 6 o'clock in the morning. It's very pleasant, and then we're going to commemorate that. The commemoration in a group is also very effective because it is spontaneous. When one person in the group makes it, then all of us feel it. Also, there would be a little change tomorrow in that we used to study Arabic after this. But point was made that after zikr was very, very high, and the other lessons were really a let down. It's like crashing down from very high. So we're going to change the Arabic language lessons to before the Quranic study as of next week. So the people who want to study Arabic will come to the mosque at 6 o'clock. And we'll study Arabic at 6 o'clock in the Quranic study. Tomorrow there will be no Arabic lessons. So we can hover up there for a while.
I can change the name.